baits are expensive, so.
Hey folks, we've got a really neat show for you today. We're in Lawrence County at Byhalia Creek, and we're going to be piggybacking on some research that the Fisheries Bureau has been doing, looking at spotted bass populations in these small wadable creeks. I've got Ryan Jones fishing with us today, Scotty Jones, myself, and Matt Roberts. And our goal is to go out here, wade the stream, wade the creek, and catch as many spotted bass as we can, and we'll mark them.
So we're carrying out what's known as a mark recapture survey. And mark recapture is just a tool that biologists use to estimate the size of fish and wildlife populations. So basically, we've been out here a couple times before. We've marked some fish. We're gonna go back out this time and look at how many fish that we marked previously that we recapture this time. If you go out and you encounter a large number of fish that we marked last time, chances are it's a small population. Yeah. If we go out and we're catching a lot of new fish, then this is a bigger population with some fish out there that we haven't met yet. We've got a hole punch. We'll take this with the captured fish and we're gonna mark the tail fin of the bass that we catch. Now we're splitting into two teams. We've got a team upstream and we've got a team downstream. Team upstream is gonna mark the fish on the upper lobe of the tail fin, and team downstream is gonna mark the lower lobe of the tail fin. If we come back next time and team downstream catches a fish that was marked in the upper lobe of the tail fin, well, that fish has migrated from where we caught it last time. That just gives us a little bit of insight on fish movement. I never catch fish this close to the bridge going this way. I reckon it's the four-wheelers. He's on, fish on, but he's also snagged.
Close combat, wasn't it?
What's that?
Close combat.
Unfortunately, this is a largemouth here.
Non-target.
On a spotted bass, I tend to see below this dark line going horizontally down the fish, I'd also see smaller lines below that are made up of little black dots going down the side. And the largemouth will lap that.
Oh, close your mouth, and that jaw, that mandible right there, the jawbone extends back past the corner of the eye, the back of the eye. It's a largemouth. The spot's gonna be about halfway. It's not gonna extend as far back.
That is the target species.
Spotted bass.
We're gonna make sure it hadn't been punched, which it hadn't. I'm gonna mark this fish, the bottom of his tail. Bottom of his, look at there.
Let me see. That was a hole punch.
See it?
Okay.
So we know when we come back, we'll be able to tell if that fish has been caught again. Throw it back, and hopefully come back and get him next time and record him as a recap.
Look at that.
Number one.
Right there.
Hey, those baits are expensive, so.
Got him, broke that. When we come fishing, you know, these wadable streams, wadable creeks, normally one of us will start with a spinnerbait or a buzzbait. And the other one will start with some kind of plastic. Matt's throwing a Texas rig or a shaky head. Plastic fishing a little slower than I am. And I'm just throwing a 3/16 ounce, 1/4 ounce spinnerbait. This is pretty basic, 6'6", medium heavy rock hole rod. 5'6", 6 foot will probably work just as good. You know, the shorter the better probably. But this is, I like the action on this rock hole. So this is what I chose to use today. And we'll keep throwing the spinnerbait, and we may change to some plastic if we have to, but I hope they keep eating the spinnerbait. Good spotted bass. No? Yeah, that's a spot. You know, this is the this is an average size spot. It probably weighs 3/4 of a pound. Just a load of fun to catch while you're wading these creeks. And that's one reason we're out here looking at the population numbers to see what kind of fishing pressure these populations could support. Again, we're gonna mark him right there. Got the hole punch, got him marked downstream. He's going right back over where I caught him. Fish number two. Get him, get him.
Jerry caught a nice largemouth on this stretch last time.
Fish?
Yep. That's gotta be a sunfish. This bait's called the Nico Helgramite, and it's on an 1/8 ounce owner rugby jig head. In those instances where the bait's down and you got little crevices that you might get snagged in with a skinnier jig head, that football shape, instead of going down in the crevice, that'll sit on top of it. And I just don't get snagged as often. The Helgramite is the larval form of the Dobson fly. And those larvae are aquatic and tend to hang out in areas where there's current. I'm switching to a little bit larger of a bait with some chartreuse color, thinking maybe that'll make the bait more visible.
Who caught that?
This guy on a spinner bait.
Spotted bass. Both the largemouth and the spotted bass have this solid line going horizontally down the fish. And the spotted bass also will have these thinner lines down below that are made up of individual dots. And we're on the downstream team, so we're marking the lower lobe. Just one punch, he's marked, he's gonna go back in.
If I can take me more of those kind of strikes when I'm not expecting it. Now that will be the lunker of the day, maybe. Maybe I will keep throwing the buzz bait. No mark, spotted bass. Downstream mark. And there he goes, right back over there. Hopscotch again.
Hey, how's he supposed to get that on camera if you say that?
We don't want to hear fish on camera.
Lower lobe of the tail fin punched. Mark there, and let's get him back. This is a long ear sunfish. Real pretty with those neon blue streaks down there.
Oop. Nope.
Bob.
Spotted. Spotted bass. Oop, don't you do it. We gotta put a hole in you. Matt, come here. Think this fish has been marked? mean, it's not a hole, but he's got something going on the lower part of his fin.
Yeah, I think that was a mark right there.
So I'm gonna record him as a recap and mark him again.
He's the first recap of the day.
And we're marking one, just one?
Yeah.
What he's doing. He's got me wound up. Pretty large, Mile. A lot of work there. Sport advice. See you, buddy. We've had a great day today on Byhalia Creek here in Lawrence County, and we're gonna get these fish marked in the bottom of their tail fin and get them released. If you're looking to have a good time, pick up some light gear, put yourself on an old pair of tennis shoes, and the next time you find yourself outdoors, maybe you can catch some spotted bass like this.
Thanks for watching this episode of Mississippi Outdoors.
We hope you enjoyed this video.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, and check out other videos from previous seasons.
And don't forget to ring the bell for notifications so you don't miss out on future shows.